Audible.com is a leading provider of audiobooks with more than 150,000 downloadable titles across all types of literature, including fiction, nonfiction, periodicals, and yes, oh yes, even yoga. Audible has free apps so you can download and listen to your iPhone, Android, Windows Phone, Kindle Fire, plus the iPod and over 500 MP3 players. Unlike a streaming service or rental service, with Audible, you own your books. If you choose a book and you decide you don't like it, no worries. You can exchange it for another title anytime. No questions asked. So download a free book of your choice today at audiblepodcast.com/yogamazing. Welcome everyone to this edition of the Yoga Amazing Video Podcast. I'm Chaz, I'm your host, and welcome back. Now, this week's class idea was submitted by John, and he basically says, Chaz, when I wake up in the morning, my body is extremely tight. Can you give me some yoga poses that will help my body wake up so that I can go through the day and be happy and feel good? Well, of course, John, yoga is a great way to stretch out your body in the morning because I know that when I wake up, you know, my body is extremely tight. So there's this class, we're going to have some basic moves that are going to help stretch your body and wake it up. So, John, thanks for submitting your idea. And if you have an idea for an upcoming class, please send it to chaz@yogamazing.com. Of course, you can find me on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. And remember, if you're looking for the archive of Yoga Amazing videos, please go to the archive at yogamazing.com website, where you can also sign up for Yoga Amazing 24/7. And you can also get the iPhone app, the iPad app, Yoga Amazing with you all the time. So go check it out, the website. So remember, as we go through today's class, to breathe, relax, and have fun in this edition of the Yoga Amazing Video Podcast. Okay, the first thing we want to do is bring ourselves to sitting in hero's pose. So how we're going to start the class today. So take your hands, palm up, and no slouching at the back. Okay, roll the shoulder blades down the back, sitting up nice and straight. Draw the navel in. And if this hurts to sit like this, you can always place a blanket or a pillow right here to take the pressure off the knees, or maybe it just hurts in your feet area. So from here, let's palms up, close your eyes, take a few moments here, just deep breathing. We're inhale through the nose, hollow the throat, expand the chest and lungs. Breathe in, breathe out, slow meditative movement, enjoy breathing. Now from here, let's bring ourselves to your hands and knees. We're going to do cat and cow pose. If this is the only pose that you do for the morning, this is probably one of the best because it really is great at awakening the spine. So from here, let's inhale, look up, shoulder blades down, spread the sits bones. And as you exhale, round, tuck, and squeeze, tucking the chin. Inhale, looking up. Shoulder blades down. Exhale, round, tuck, and squeeze. Now set your own pace, set your own rhythm. Breathing in as you look up, and exhaling as you tuck under. Nice, slow, fluid movements. Two more. And then bring yourself back to the center. We're going to dig our toes into the mat and go to downward facing dog. Again, a great pose. Stretch you from your fingertips to your heels. So coming up, push back. Remember, going for an upside down V. your heels don't hit the floor, it just means they don't hit the floor, no big deal. Work on opening the body, because if this is in the morning, you know your body's going to be tight. So just breathe and just work on getting your proper alignment. Deepen your breath. Make sure your feet are hips width apart. Your neck is long. Shoulder blades draw apart. Pull them down the back. Release. Sitting on your heels, hero's pose for a moment. And taking it right back up into down dog. And again, same thing. Bend your knees, push back, going for that upside down V. Work your heels to the floor, but let them open up. Because a lot of times people push their heels to the floor and they round forward. It's not what we want. We want a nice, straight, sliding board spine. Deep in your breath. Now look between your hands. We're going to bring the right foot forward into a warrior one lunge. So you're going to keep your heel up off the floor and you're going to really root into it. So get yourself set and then bring the arms up, firming up that back leg. So the back leg, don't let the knee bend down. Pull the kneecap, the knee back. Draw the shoulder blades down the back. Breathe into it. And release. Go back to a down dog for just a breath and switch it to the other side. Get yourself set, get your balance, firming up that back leg, bringing the arms up, breathe into it. Slowly release, coming up. Hands on the hips. Now, you're gonna take your foot out in this one. We're doing warrior two. So you're gonna bring your arms up. Big inhale, open up your stance as comfortably wide as you can, okay? Take a big inhale. And then as you exhale, bend that front leg. And if you can open up your stance wider to eventually, I always tell people to where you can get this horizontal to the floor like that, where you can put a cup of coffee on it. Now that's a pretty intense stretch through here. If you need to, pull it back, you know, make it wherever it works for you. Alignment though, knee over ankle. So open it up as best you can. Arms up, draw the shoulder blades down the back. Remember, you don't want to reach forward. You want your spine to be vertical. Arms up. So this is the present, past, future. We don't want to be here, here. We want to be here, right in the center. So gaze forward, deepen the breath. Slowly release, hands to the hips. Just rotate it right into the other side. Same thing comes into play here. Inhale, and then as you exhale, we're gonna bend that front leg. Again, don't lean forward, don't lean back. Find your center point. Heel to arch, depending on where you are. Knee over ankle. Open it up as wide as you comfortably can. Slowly release. Hands to the hips. From here, extended side, wide angle. So, I'm gonna rotate to the other side again. Arms up, big inhale. And then as you exhale, you're gonna bend that front leg again. I'm giving you two options here. One is you can bring your arm here and here. Okay, this is the simplified version. Now, if you wanna go deeper, you take your hand to the floor. So you have your choices. Looking up under the arm towards the ceiling. Deepen your breath. And release. Bringing it up. Let's rotate it to the other side. I'll do it the same way I did here. So inhale. And as you exhale, release into the pose, simplified version or the advanced version. Breathe, find out where you are, go there. And bring it up. Hands to the hips. Big inhale, lift into the heart. And then as you exhale, take your hands, fingertips to the floor, spreading your sits bones, squeezing into the root. And just hang here deep in the breath. Go breath by breath, take it down. You're gonna feel the stretch all in your legs. And then slowly walk it up. Wiggle your feet in. Bring it into Tadasana, the mountain pose, for a few breaths. And from here, we're gonna work on tree pose, Vrikshasana. So we're gonna bring our foot into our inner thigh. And then slowly release. Now remember, as you're doing this pose, you can kickstand it, bring it here, or you can bring it all the way up, firming up this leg to get your balance. Set your gaze, your drishti, so that you can get your focus. And then you want to feel like someone's pulling a thread through your crown of your head that's lengthening your spine. So find your balance, deepen the breath. Slowly release. From here, we're just gonna bring it right down to our knees for a camel pose. So I'll turn this way so you can see. And you wanna make sure now, some people have the capabilities of putting their feet down or their toes back, or by digging in with your toes, it makes it a little bit easier so you can get into it properly. So you know which one's best for you. But remember that when you're doing this, don't do this, okay? You're getting nothing out of that. What you wanna do is get that nice, big, deep bow. So you're bringing your hips forward, rolling the shoulders, and getting that real big opening. So we don't want it to be like a bad pose. So remember that. So from here, hands to the heels, big inhale, lift into the heart. And as you exhale, hips go slightly forward. Breathe. Slowly release and take it forward into a child's pose just to stretch it out. From here, we're going to bring ourselves to sitting. We're going to get a couple of nice twist pose in here and then relax. So from here, big inhale, lift into the heart, lengthen and twist. Breathe and twist little by little. Slowly release, come back to the center. Inhale and exhale. And then bring it back to the center. Do that one more time, each side. Inhale and exhale. exhale. And crisscross your legs the other way. And the same thing, inhaling and exhale. And release. From here, instead of going into Shavasana, the resting pose, since we are waking up, or this is the morning, we don't want to go back into that state. We want to go into much more of a meditative feeling to awaken the mind. So from here, we're just going to do a seated meditation for a bit. Just close your eyes, palms up, big inhales, big exhales. Just take these next few minutes to just awaken your body, awaken your mind even more through deep breathing and relaxation. Take the peace and the strength and share it. Namaste.